In order to be a referee in the sport of boxing, there are some important requirements. Among the most important, ignore the crowd. You have to make the call to what you see inside the ropes, not what you hear outside. Ignore the protests of a fighter if the fight is stopped. Your job is to enforce the rules and protect the fighter's life by making the right call. All of those things, all of those qualities, and more are a great way to describe our next inductee. He was born on June 2nd, 1954 in Buffalo, New York. He began working in boxing in 1994 when he joined USA Boxing. He would spend the next 10 years learning all facets of the game and becoming a boxing official. In those 10 years, he worked more than 1,100 amateur bouts, 442 as a ref, 645 as a judge, and even 20 as a timekeeper. 1999, he stepped up to the next level and began to work in the pros. He started as a judge, worked 172 bouts, including numerous title fights with Florida Boxing Hall of Fame inductees Antonio Tarver, Nate Campbell, and David Santos. 2004, he turned his attention to becoming a referee and has not looked back since. He's worked more than 400 professional bouts. He's worked title bouts for all the major organizations, the WBA, WBC, WBO, NBA, IBO, and others. He's appeared on all the major networks, HBO, Showtime, ESPN, Telemundo. Among the most notable fighters that he's refereed, the list includes Florida Boxing Hall of Famers like Antonio Tarver, Nate Campbell Jr., Jeff Lacy, Uriah Grant, Freeman Barr, David Santos, and more. He also refereed six of world champion Keith Thurman's fights, including his pro debut. Even when he's not working, he is a big boxing fan. He has amassed an amazing collection of autographed boxing gloves signed by some of the biggest names in history. Also, when he's not working, he is the creator of energy webs, and he's an award-winning glass artist. One-of-a-kind works of modern glass art. Oh, and in his spare time, he's also an award-winning screenwriter, having won awards in the Nichols Fellowship, TV Me Contest, American Screenwriters Association, and Writer's Digest, just to name a few. If you're looking at refereeing as an art form, ladies and gentlemen, we have quite the artist joining us this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame, Class of 2022, boxing referee, Dennis DeBON.
Thank you all. I'd just like to thank all the people from the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame, especially Steve Canton and Bob Alexander for this great honor, and I'm very proud to be here. I've been refereeing for 28 years now, and in those 28 years, I constantly get asked two questions. One, how do you become a boxing referee? Number two, have you ever been hit? I get that all the time. It's kind of like asking David Tua or Shannon Briggs, have you guys ever been hit in a ring? Same thing. As a referee, we get hit. And for the longest time, I could always say, I've never been hit above the neck or below the belt. Well, that changed. I was at the Alucard Pavilion. I was doing a pro debut for the boxer. I knew his adrenaline was up. The bell rings to end the round, and he throws a late punch, which I was ready for. I got out of the way of that punch. I wasn't expecting him to throw two late punches after the bell. Bam, right in the face. And being the third man in the ring, and I'm sure you boxers all know too, you hear that crowd noise. Well, when I got hit in the face with that punch, I heard that crowd noise. It was pretty amazing, actually. Yeah, I should have gave myself a standing eight count, right? So as far as becoming a referee, if there's any young people out there that are interested in being in that field, the best thing to do is I was advised to join USA Boxing and start out in the amateurs, and I would advise that to anybody that is interested in becoming a referee. And also to get into the boxing ring and a referee and just get in the ring with a sparring match and just get in there and move around the ring and get used to that. There are some names I do want to mention. Some of these people have passed. Some are still with us. I do want to keep their memory alive. When I first started out in the amateurs 28 years ago, there were a couple gentlemen, Sid Pittman and Al Moran. They were referees at that time. Some of you might remember Riley Carter, too, Nick Cemento and his wife, Joyce, Frank Filiberto and his wife, Chris. And once I got up to the professional ranks, there's Frank Skillbred, Don Hazelton, Max Parker Jr., and my 28-year mentor, if he's still here with us, Brian Gary. You still here? Hey, there he is back there. Hey, Brian, please stand up. Would everybody give this man a round of applause? He still mentors me, and he still gives me crap when I get out of the ring. And so thank you very much, Brian. They say that if you're passionate about something, it's really not work. When I get into the ring, I don't want the – where's Tim? Oh, Tim. I just want you to know that I would work for free, but, you know, don't tell anybody else that, okay? I just want to thank you again. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate it.